guys gonna kill Ferris?
No. No, you won't find her. You won't see her for a long time.
Hey, calm down. You aren't making any sense.
I just got a call from Tallulah's mom. And she told me that Tallulah was in a car accident on Willow Avenue last night. And she
what? Died? Oh, come on, Judy. That couldn't have happened. What kind of a joke do you think you're playing here?
Oh, this isn't a joke. Tallulah is gone.
Oh my God. How long has she, you know?
Like I was trying to tell you, she was driving to your house last night and got in a car accident on Willow Avenue. Drunk driver hit her and she died on sight.
This is all my fault.
This is not your fault. It's the driver's fault. He was the one who was being irresponsible.
She was coming to my house. She wasn't comfortable with driving, so I was supposed to pick her up. She needed to see me.
Ollie, stop blaming yourself. You didn't do anything.
But if I went to her, maybe she would be fine. Maybe she would be right here with us.
What do you want me to say? Maybe she would be, maybe it is on her fault. Maybe if she'd come to talk to me, she'd be safe. She's my best friend. She should have come to my place instead.
June, she's my friend too. And do you even know why she was coming over?
No, I still don't see why she couldn't come talk to me.
It was about you, June. You say the harshest things to her and she always has them on her mind.
What in the world are you talking about?
Do you not remember anything? A few weeks ago you told her, hey Lou, do you really need to eat all of that? Another time you said, I don't think you should wear that, Lou. It shows too much. Not to mention all the things you say behind her back.
None of those things are true, and she knew that!
Well, obviously she didn't. She wouldn't have had to come over if you were more careful about the things you say.
You know what? I'm so surprised she was going to go talk to you. Out of all people, it was you.
What does that even mean?
She knew that you wanted to make a move. And that's why she was never alone with you. She was scared of you, Oliver. She wasn't ready for any relationship.
I wouldn't do that to her. I wouldn't try to hurt her.
Neither would her parents. That's where she should have been. With her parents. She would have been safe and maybe alive.
She could have died on her way over there, too. She had to take Lily and her parents.
Don't yell at me! Just wait! Get out of my apartment!
I was thinking the same thing.
Sorry,
I'm sorry I didn't say
anything. Stop. You go first.
Listen, I'm sorry for yelling at you a few weeks ago. It just happened and I lost control. And I'm sorry I didn't say anything at the funeral. It just didn't feel right.
Yeah, it's fine. I'm sorry for not saying anything either. Sorry for fighting back. It wasn't my place to say any of that.
How did we turn this on? I get you some water. You need something after all that crying.
I'm not thirsty either. She was in charge of finally woke up and was functioning perfectly. And was so excited that the girl was finally going home to her family. You should have heard her, Ollie. She woke up. The first thing she did was smile and gave a little wave for her mom. It was brilliant.
She was fantastic at what she did. Her passion was always so inspiring.
What can I do without her? What am I gonna do when I get my heart broken and can't go to them? What's gonna happen when something exciting happens and we won't get to share it with each other? She's the one who takes care of me when I'm sick or when I'm stressed. She always knew exactly what I needed. Her hugs somehow managed to help me forget every worry I ever had. Her cooking sent me to another world.
Her fettuccine alfredo was the best I've ever had. Is new, and I don't know what to do with it. I'm so angry and so afraid, not just for myself, but for Lou too. She had everything going for her. She was working as a nurse at the hospital. She was moving into her own apartment. She was on top of the world. And then it was taken from her. It was ripped out of her hands by someone who probably hurt her. She's gone because of breathlessness. And I thought that I was feeling this all on my own. And that no one cared for Lou as much as I did. But I'm not alone. Her parents, her little brother, all her family, all her friends, and you. You understand this group. We're not alone. I wouldn't know what to do if you weren't here by my side, allowing me to let it out. So thank you.
I wouldn't know what to do with all this hurt. I wouldn't know what to do without you either. So
them come here to bring me flowers and talk about our trips and memories. They talk about my most embarrassing moments, like our trip to the mountains and how I scared all the deer away. I wish I could have experienced everything with them in person. I was there, every single step of the way. I want to tell them how proud I am of them. I wish I could hug them both and tell them I love them so much, just one last time. I want to tell June how happy I am for her and how beautiful she looked on her wedding. I was screaming with excitement and joy at Oliver's graduation. His smile was the biggest I've ever seen. I wish I could have been there when he got the news about getting his dream job. That would have been wonderful. Somehow, they took their pain and flipped it around and built good things on it. They turned their pain into power and accepted the worst. They accepted that I was gone. And if they can, then I guess I need to too. I don't want to leave them, but I know they'll be okay on their own. I guess it's my time to move on. I'll miss them so much.